All right, we'll take a look at the 76ers. They have high expectations this year, and they will do so with a squad that's seen a lot of changes. Remember, in the offseason, key contributors are gone, mostly shooters and closers. Jimmy Butler's out. J.J. Redick is out. But, you know, Philly All-Star Al Horford is on the way. Josh Richardson is there, and he's a two-way star. So let's walk through the expectations that we have for the 76ers coming into this season. For you, J. Will.
Yep, go ahead. You could say it.
I know. He's already picked them to win the title.
Yes.
Just period. So we're going to start there, Jalen.
Uh-huh.
Just sit back.
Go ahead.
And listen to why that's going to happen.
Win the East or win the title?
No.
Look, I think they're going to be the best defensive team in the league. I think them and the Clippers are the best defensive team in the league. And
facts.
I think what's going to happen
facts.
In the West is you're going to have all these teams that are going to beat up on each
True
other.
True or false, you picked the 76ers.
I did.
Okay.
I'm on it right now.
Okay.
I'm not even laughing about it. I'm telling you seriously. I think it's a chance for them.
Well, this gentleman isn't far off, Maria, because mm-hmm. I picked them to win the Eastern Conference as well. Now, if Ben Simmons is making jump shots, that puts them in position to win it all, but I still have to go with it. If you come out of the gauntlet in the Western Conference, to me, you got to be favorite. There's so many top teams out there. The Lakers, the Clippers, the Rockets are all going to be in the conversation. Don't sleep on the Denver Nuggets, the Utah Jazz. So the Sixers have a chance to take an easier path.
That's my point.
If they could get series over with 4-0, 4-1, that type of thing.
I agree with you. And I think, you know, nobody talks about Matisse Thybul. Mm-hmm. Like, he's one of the best defenders that's going to be in the league as a rookie. So I think they have the pieces to match up against Giannis pretty well.
Well, Jalen brought it up.
You're not laughing at me now, though.
I'm not.
So when Jalen backs me, now
when
all of a sudden
Jalen
it's not funny.
Says it, I believe it. When Jay Will says it, I struggle a little
questionable.
Bit.
I'm just an elder statesman. One name, okay. One name that we didn't mention is going to be key for Philadelphia. Josh Richardson.
Agreed.
Yes.
You talk about them playing D. He's a terrific athlete. He's an improved shooter. That level of effort is going to make a difference playing against so many top point guards.
Remind us, Jay Will, why Ben Simmons' shot is going to be better, because you've done some recon there.
I just think this summer has been huge for him, because I think a lot of times, you know this, when you first come into the league, the amount of people that you listen to influences your confidence. So I think for him, he's decreased that. It's only his, you know, shooting coach Chris Johnson and his head coach Brett Brown. And I think this summer I've seen it. It's different.
But
it's
you know what's different? Being followed by the media as a basketball player, or being followed by the paparazzi. Right?
Fair.
Okay.
Facts.
So now he said he fell back in love with the game.
Yes. Yeah.
So now his jump shot seems to be something that he's
right. Elder yeah. statesman.
The Lakers, they are projected to finish with 50 wins. That's the fifth best in the West, just behind those retooled Rockets. As for the under-the-radar teams, Utah with their new additions, Denver also with the all-star Nikola Jokic, and they're projected to have the second most wins in the West at 52. So, shall we run the floor in the wild, wild West, Jalen and Jay Will?
Let's get it.
All right, Jalen, let's start with you. How important will home court advantage be in the West?
It's going to be extremely important. And unlike the numbers that was just up on the screen, don't bet on the Clippers to have the best record in the West.
Facts.
I got two words for you, load management. There's going to be a lot of that taking place as Paul George recovers from his shoulder surgery earlier in the year.
Denver has the best chance to have has the best record because they come at you in waves. 10 players that have played over 1,000 minutes last year.
All
That's
right.
How they play.
Well, you guys kind of brought up the concerns then. How do you deal with what might be the injury that's going to harp with Paul George, could lead into the season, and Kawhi making sure that he's not playing too many games? How do you handle it?
You bring Kawhi into the fold when it fits. Kawhi will dictate that. Last year, he played 60 games. Paul George has had surgeries on both shoulders, his right rotator cuff, his left labrum, so that will come back towards missing. But you also have Lou Will. You forget, like, Lou Will and Montrezl Harrell, they came off the bench. They were dominating second units last year. So you got a guy who is three-time sixth man of the year. He'll carry the load.
So they got a little bit of depth there
that
they can rely on. Jalen, who is one of the best teams out of the West nobody's talking about right now?
Well, there is a couple, Maria. Jay just mentioned the Denver Nuggets, and rightfully so. I think people are sleeping on the Utah Jazz. They're going to be one of those teams that's up for possibly having the best regular season record. But you can't sleep again on the Denver Nuggets. Like Jay said, they just have so much depth.
All right, let's talk through the West a little bit and how you think it's going to shake out, because I think that you had picked the Lakers, essentially, to win the entire title. You are going with the 76ers, so you're not a part of this conversation. How do the Lakers handle, I mean, they have a lot of changes, too, and not a lot of depth, and maybe an injury away from having issues down the stretch?
When the playoffs come, you rely on your stars. Mm-hmm. The Lakers have two of the top five players in the game that are compatible with one another. LeBron James, Anthony Davis, high pick and roll. You decide to switch it. AD can pop, and make the jump shot, he can post up smaller guards. Of course, each team has weaknesses. Mm-hmm. Who's going to be the finisher at the point guard spot? When Rajon Rondo has the ball, that means LeBron James does not have the ball. That's not a formula for success. I think it'll be Danny Green. I think it'll be Avery Bradley guarding the other team's point guards. But I feel like in a playoff series, the Los Angeles Lakers have what it takes to possibly win it all.
We talk a lot about the projections of the regular season, but as J. Rose said, load management, mm-hmm. Paul George coming back, it's not about where you are in the regular season, it's about where you are fully healthy during the playoffs when that time comes around. I'm still rocking with the Clippers. I just think from top to bottom, soup to nuts, they are one of the best defensive teams in the league. Now, we'll get a chance to see Kawhi go against LeBron. I mean, that's going to be the battle right there. And if Kawhi feels like he is healthy at that stage, because I think LeBron is going to have an MVP-caliber type season this season.
Yeah, they have two of the best defenders for sure in Paul George and Kawhi. You kind of talked about which teams are set for the regular season. Who is best able to have a successful regular season? Like, who could walk away with the win but not necessarily win the entire shit?
So, on paper, I would say the Lakers and the Clippers should be the Western Conference final. Mm-hmm. But the problem is they won't have the first and the second best records mm-hmm. in the conference, which means they may face each other in the second round. The teams that you're talking about, Utah mm-hmm. is going to be in the conversation, adding Mike Conley at the point guard spot. Denver, Jokic is going to be an MVP candidate. He's going to be amongst the league leaders in multiple statistical categories. Those couple of teams are going to surprise a lot of people.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN Plus right now.